Hello and welcome to Prague, the convent of Saint Agnes. My name is Misha and we have Nicola behind the camera. On today's video, we're gonna talk about the greatest woman in Czech history, a princess of Bohemia of the Przemysl dynasty, a mother superior and a founder of two religious orders, Saint Agnes of Bohemia. So why don't you come with us and we'll show you various locations connected to Saint Agnes, and then you can follow these footsteps when you come to Prague yourself. Saint Agnes was the daughter to King Przemysl Otakar I, one of the most powerful men in Europe at that time. Her father made partnership with the Holy Roman Emperor, who had a son. And so the son and Agnes were to be married. It didn't work out. And later on, the emperor became a suitor of Saint Agnes himself, and even an English king of the Plantagenet dynasty wanted to marry Princess Agnes. She refused them. She chose a different groom for herself, God. And she dedicated her life to helping the poor and the sick, and she lived in complete poverty in this convent. Nowadays, the convent of Saint Agnes belongs to the National Gallery. It hosts its permanent exposition of medieval art. And then there's this room, a hidden gem for those of you with children. It's an open studio with lots of fun and educational activities for kids of all ages. Oh, and it's open daily, except for Mondays. And it's free of charge. In this beautiful convent garden and courtyard, you can experience the legacy of Saint Agnes of Bohemia, even yourself. During Anežská life cycle, they organize yoga classes, concerts, festivals, performances for families with children. They have expositions of sculptures of modern art. There is literally everything for everyone. We're standing now in front of a church of Saint Francis of Assisi. Next to it is the Charles Bridge Museum. It hosts a beautiful exposition dedicated not only to Saint Agnes of Bohemia, but also to the Order of the Knights of the Holy Cross and the Red Star. That is a truly Czech order and also the only male order in history ever founded by a woman, Saint Agnes. On this model, we can see the original church of Saint Francis as it was seen by Saint Agnes in the 13th century. And attached to this church is the Judith Bridge, which was built at the end of the 12th century by Queen Judith. And I'm going to take you underneath this arch right here. The Charles Bridge Museum is operated by Prague-Venice Boat Company. So if you come to Prague and want to experience some of the places that saw St. Agnes, hop on one of their boats. You're going to sail underneath not only the Charles Bridge, but also the last preserved arch of the Romanesque Judith Bridge. Saint Agnes was born in 1211, and imagine, it took almost 800 years for her to be officially proclaimed saint for her deeds. That magical year came in 1989. That was when almost 10,000 Czechoslovakians came to Rome. They took buses, trains, flew by a plane, drove their cars to see John Paul II, the Pope, proclaiming Saint Agnes saint. It happened on 12th of November, and they say that it took Saint Agnes afterwards 5 days with all the courage and strength that she could master to help Czechoslovakia find the peace and freedom on 17th of November 1989, when the Velvet Revolution began. Saint Agnes was an exceptional female figure in our history. In fact, her importance traveled far beyond the borders of our country. Despite the fact that 60% of us Czechs are agnostics, we still admire her patience, humility, modesty, love for all people, and especially her willingness to help those in need. And that's something worth remembering even after 800 years, especially these days. Thank you for joining us today as we followed the footsteps of Saint Agnes of Bohemia. And if you'd like to see more videos of us, please join our YouTube channel, click on that subscribe button below, and we'll see you soon here in Prague. Ahoj!